It's time for the match game, Hollywood Squares, our win from Dukes of Hazzard, Sorrell Booke. From One Day at a Time, Michael Lembeck. Jayne Kennedy. Marty Cohen. Marcia Wallace. And the stars of the match game, Hollywood Squares Hour, Gene Rayburn and John Bowman.
Are we on?
We are on.
I was just captivated by the beauty of Miss Kennedy, and I...
We are all captivated by the beauty of Miss Kennedy.
She's such a lovely thing.
I got to sit next to Sorrell.
Hey, listen. Yeah.
I was captivated by the beauty of Sorrell.
If I drew your face up here...
Wait a minute. Then we would be able to see him, too.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, do that.
They want to see you, so I'll just draw your eyes and a nose and a mouth.
No, we'll just draw the hair. We'll just
We're
draw
very easily them. Entertained on this show.
That's right. Everybody ready?
Yes. Ready.
Are you ready, Michael?
Ready.
Okay.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Are you ready?
Have you got anything to say?
Figures.
I have nothing to say, Gene. I'm never speaking again.
He's so funny.
Isn't he funny?
I'm blushing. Play the game, Uncle Gene.
Oh, all right.
Okay.
It didn't work, did it?
No.
It'll work. It takes like 45 minutes in. It'll be funny.
Okay. Let's begin the match game here by introducing our two players, Annette Ruhn and Elizabeth Tamarit. Hello. Welcome.
Thank you.
Let's get acquainted. We're going to find out a little bit here about Annette first. Tell us a little bit about you, please.
I'm an insurance agent.
Mm-hmm. I'm sorry. I gave it the... At my home, I mailed checks in last week, as a matter of fact.
Good, you covered.
Yikes.
I've been married forever. I'm a native Californian. I like to read. I'm an avid reader, and I like to work backstage at my community theater.
Good for you. That's a wonderful thing to do. What is your last play you did?
The last play we did was Six Rooms Riverview.
Six, yes?
Yes, and I was stage manager, which is nice because I get to boss everybody around.
Good, yeah, that's it. All right, Annette, good luck to you. Elizabeth, let's hear about you, please.
Hi, I'm married.
Yes?
My husband's in the audience.
Is he here?
Yeah, he's up there somewhere.
What's his first name?
Miguel.
Miguel?
Yeah.
Hello, Miguel. You have a very pretty wife. How long have you been married, Miguel?
Almost a year.
Almost a year. What are you doing around here? What else? About
we live in Norwalk. We have a son.
Mm-hmm.
I'm presently a housewife, and up to about a couple months ago, I was involved in the health club business. I worked in a health fund as a manager.
You're healthy.
Very.
You're in good physical condition.
I think so.
All right. Good luck to you. Let's begin the match game. You'll have three chances to match as many of the stars as you can. And the winner will go on to challenge the returning champion in Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Annette, you won the toss. We'll ask you to go first.
A, please.
All right. A says, Dumb Donald is the world's dumbest lifeguard. Oh, I'm sorry. Your heart's not in it.
I can be water.
Here's how dumb he is. He once gave mouth-to-mouth resuscitation to a blank.
He's the dumbest what?
World's dumbest lifeguard.
Lifeguard.
Good slap, Jayne.
Coming up.
And away we go. Ready, John?
Sir.
Annette, Dumb Donald is the world's dumbest lifeguard. He once gave mouth-to-mouth resuscitation to a blank.
A beach ball.
A beach ball. Hey, had a way to go, Annette. She says a beach ball.
Let's go.
All right, that's anything dumb like that would be good. Have you got a dumb one?
Any derivative? Well, I have the wrong material, actually. I went more towards the, What is that stuff made of?
Terry cloth.
Terry cloth. I went into the terry cloth mold. Towel.
A towel. Don't boo that.
Oh, come on.
That's very good. Don't boo that.
And they wonder why they can't stop the arms freeze.
Right. No, terry cloth is good. Beach ball is good. Have you got a good one? A real dumb one?
Oh, I just love to be with you. I love all the things you say and do. And there's no argument from you at all, because you're my inflatable party doll. Oh, inflatable doll.
Okay. How dumb was he, Jayne?
Well, let me see. I just said a turtle because it was the first thing that popped in my head.
It's all right.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a boo.
That's right. That's crazy. A plot turtle and boo a towel. Yeah, Michael can't figure you out, friends. Okay, he once gave mouth-to-mouth to A.
Annette Rune, huh?
Yeah.
I know your husband, Macca. Macaroon.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Now, sure enough.
See, now I have a strategy here.
What's that?
I have a strategy. I get the boo out of their system before the actual answer. Fish.
Fish is good.
They weren't finished, were
Sorrell,
they?
Does it hurt you to be booed?
The only thing that hurts is I got the same thing here.
A residual.
See, because that could match many things.
Still fish is a good response. Sure. Marcia?
You think if I told them that I love to be booed and begged them to boo me?
It would be just like yesterday. It would
be perverse.
It would be sort of perverse and work the other way. We'll see. Fish.
Mezzo. A few booed and a few applauded. All right, Elizabeth, this is what we have for you. Norman said, I think my wife is having an affair with the postman. Last night when she came to bed, she had blank stamped on her thigh. Got one?
Yeah.
Good one, Jayne?
I think so. Yes.
All right, the bottom tier is ready. Ready, Michael. Elizabeth. Norman said, I think my wife is having an affair with the postman. Last night when she came to bed, she had blank stamped on her thigh.
I've had these before.
You've had this before?
Return to sender is the only thing I can think of.
Return to sender?
Yeah.
Was there? You don't like that one? That's not a bad one. There are a lot of them. You know, the postmen have all those stamps that they have in the back of the counter there.
Yeah.
A return to sender is indeed.
What's wrong with that?
Nothing.
Nothing.
That's a good answer. Nothing.
Well, the audience is...
You go out there and shape them up.
Weird.
Yes. Shape them up.
I shall walk
shape
among
up.
You with a large stick.
And smack
and
them.
Beat
shape
you.
Up. Shape up. Oh, I knew it.
They're into it.
Right.
Now, listen, I have a very creative answer. Give them the thing, and I'm going to put it up, and I expect the proper response here.
Last night when she came to bed, she had blank stamped on her thigh.
Okay. An affair with the postman, blank stamped on her thigh, sealed with a kiss.
No.
Have to know.
All right.
Do you know what's a small world? Elizabeth is from Norwalk, and it just so happens that Michael and I both know the Norwalk City Cheer. Do you know the cheer?
What is a city cheer for Norwalk?
It goes, we don't jog, we don't run, Norwalk, Norwalk.
You guys are crazy. And that's why you're here.
I said, I don't know, do not bend.
Do not bend.
These people are
What do you folks want?
Blood up here?
Do not fold, staple, or mutilate. That's something else.
Yeah.
Do not bend.
What is a postman now? Give us a postman stamp, Jayne, proper.
Well, see, the postman has to make his rounds, you know, so he can't spend an awful lot of time at one stop. So I just put return to sender.
Hey!
Next one for Elizabeth.
Now they're cheering, aren't they?
Yes.
Didn't they boo before return to sender?
Mm-hmm.
No, it's the first time. Oh, they booed her.
They booed it when Elizabeth,
they booed
said,
when
it.
Elizabeth
sure.
said it. Sure,
but a beautiful woman like Jayne Kennedy says it.
What is that?
You know
what
that
make Elizabeth?
I'll bet if you said it, they'd boo you.
Yeah, what does that mean?
Let's find out. Return to sender. Okay, that's it. Bring in the relief co-host.
What do you got, Sorrell?
Well, I thought the postman would want her to get back as soon as she could, you know, deliver her home immediately. So the husband wouldn't...
Special delivery is what Sorrell Book says, all right?
Wait a minute. I expected at least...
There's a compassionate boo. There's a compassionate boo.
Marcia?
Do you think they're booed out?
They may be.
They may be, but we're not.
Have they given enough boo for this evening?
Yeah. No, I think there's a little boo-boo left
there's
in them.
This doesn't make sense, Jayne, but that's my job. That's
right.
Why I'm
that's
here.
That's exactly
right. It's a dirty
right.
job. Somebody's got to do it. Past due.
Past due.
That's a good one.
Thank you very much.
You are not a discriminating bunch. You don't know when to boo and when to cheer. Now, listen, it's 2-0 in your favor, and that's round one. Round two right after this, if you please. Here we go with round two. Elizabeth, your head will ask you to go first.
Okay, I'll take A.
A is what you want. A is what you get. Joan Rivers said, can we talk? She said that. She said, can we talk? I look great on TV, right? But I wear so much makeup that when I get home, I have to take it off with a blank. Now, you're all in show business. That ought to be easy for you. Here we go. Joan Rivers said, can we talk? I look great on TV, right? But I wear so much makeup that when I get home, I have to take it off with a blank.
Spatula.
Spatula.
Yeah.
All right. Now, we may have a sticky wicket here. I mean, will spatula match putty knife and all of that? Well, we'll find out in a moment or so.
Did somebody
if
say
someone
putty knife?
Says putty knifer.
You ready?
Oh, I don't know.
Yeah. Well,
Michael?
Give one, me the cheer
two,
one more
three,
time.
Four.
We don't skip. We don't hop. Nor walk. Nor walk.
Waiter!
Check, please.
Check, well, please.
I don't have spatula.
You don't have spatula?
And at the risk of great physical harm, I do have Brillo pad.
Brillo pad! They're unpredictable. Unpredictable.
I thank you.
All right.
This isn't going to do a whole lot for Joni's complexion, but I said she would take it off with an ice pick. I've worked with Joan Rivers. I know Joan Rivers.
You can't
I can
take
make
makeup off with an ice pick.
Sure, if little by little.
Yeah, you take forever. You don't play, and John doesn't play. Sorrell, you play.
Yeah, it was so cold, she had to take it off with a chisel.
With a chisel. All right.
I am crazy about Joan Rivers. She is a hilarious, brilliant,
she's
beautiful
wonderful,
woman.
Wonderful, yes.
Wonderful. That does not stop me, however, from going for the cheap joke. And the wrong answer, Wrecking Crew.
Wrecking Crew.
You deserve the boo.
They don't even know what they're saying. They don't know why they're here. They don't know who they are.
All right. Spatula was excellent. Annette, we've got this for you. Gilligan said, I think we've been shipwrecked on this island too long. The skipper just asked me to blink.
And we talk about standards and practices.
Right.
Can we talk?
You guys are having a good time.
We're having fun, you know.
That's
separate
wonderful.
Separate them up, Uncle Jayne.
Separate them up.
They can't sit together if they're
okay,
gonna talk
Jayne?
Like that.
Okay. Here comes.
Annette. You know who Gilligan is?
Sure do.
Gilligan said, I think we've been shipwrecked on this island too long. The skipper just asked me to blank.
Marry him.
Marry him. She gets right to it. That's good. Skipper
you know
just
that they named
to...
a famous Broadway musical after Annette, and they called it Brigaroon.
Brigaroon.
I've got a great comeback. You ready? You ready for the comeback?
Right.
All right? All right? Marion?
Marion!
Got a way to go, Michael.
When you do a joke on the show that doesn't work, you got to do what John does to get out of trouble. He just goes like this. Whenever he's in trouble, that's true. You know, that's why they called. They were on the island too long. That's why Skipper kept calling him his little buddy. You know what he meant by that? Hey, little buddy. No, Skipper, not tonight. So I said the Skipper, I wasn't quite into marriage. I said the Skipper asked him to dance.
Uh-huh.
Oh, they are merciless.
Mixed emotions. I get mixed emotions.
That's a preliminary to asking him to get married. Okay. We
didn't
got the
work
idea.
For you either.
No, it only works for John.
Okay. I figured you had to go one step before you ask him to marry you, so I said play doctor.
Play doctor. Aha. Nifty. All right, John.
Well, you know how one thing leads to another, so maybe this will match. The skipper asked him to go out with him. To the chapel. There wasn't much of anywhere to go. It was a small island. Go for it, John. Give me your best shot. John,
yes.
You know what you got to do now, John.
Is looking for nuptials here.
Yeah.
Well, now, when you hold your card up, hold it up
I'll
here.
I'll hold it over there.
So it really doesn't. Because if you hold it in front of your mom.
I understand.
Are you going to stay in show business?
Yeah, I am. But I only had this dance again because I didn't know they were shipwrecked that long.
All right.
Hello. I was lucky enough to catch one of John's answers here. I'm going to keep this for my memorabilia, for my museum later.
Always the bridesmaid.
Yes. My father's probably selling my old gym socks even as we speak. He'll want this for noon rush at Wallace Sundries. I'm surprised at you, Annette, that you would go right for the marriage. I mean, I'm a woman of standards. They're awfully low, but I do have...
Time's up.
So I said go steady and or date first.
Go steady and or date.
They have taken you to their hearts. Okay, that's round two. 2-1 to score. A tight game going here. Third and final round right after this. Okay, here we go with the third and final round. Elizabeth, you're still ahead. We ask you to go first.
A, please.
All right. Four people play, Michael, Marty, Sorrell, and Marcia. Old Man Periwinkle said,
oh, here he is again.
We've got a special song for all the folks here at the home. It's called Baby, the Blanks Must Fall. Do-da, do-da.
Whose question is this?
All right, Elizabeth. Old Man Periwinkle said, we've got a special song for all the folks here at the home. It's called Baby, the Blanks Must Fall. She's agonizing over her answer.
All I can think of is dentures. I mean, some
dentures.
Dentures. That's it.
She said dentures, Michael. What do you say?
Here's what I say. 1, 2, 3, 4.
We don't foxtrot. We don't porka. Norwalk. Norwalk. Okay. We don't fox out. We don't porka.
Porka.
Well, let's go.
Close,
polka,
but yeah.
Polka.
We keep trying. We figure
Waiter
it'll work.
Doesn't work.
Waiter. Anyway, now I think this deserves the big round of applause because these are the same things, right?
Yes, indeed. There's a match. Okay. All right, Marty, go.
Well, I was thinking of the female members of the old folks' home.
So you say.
Baby, the boobs must fall.
Right.
Baby,
okay, Sorrell, what have you got? Just hold it right up here.
Right there.
Right there.
I didn't want to put it in front of my
that's
face.
Another match.
Geez.
Yes.
Get them out of here. All right, now you see, I started with Den for dentures. Then I decided to just get a serious, literal, and boring my attorneys and said body.
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 All right, so.
Body boo.
You're right. This time you're right.
She picked up two more there. Let's see what we've got. Annette, you. Here's what you have to do. You need 3 to tie and 4 to win. Milton said, I just had dinner with the Fat family and they're a bunch of pigs. Instead of putting the food on plates, they just ate it out of a blank.
I don't answer this.
You don't play. Fat family and they're a bunch of pigs.
Well, I don't. Played by the rules.
Right. Lay it in the slot and away we go. Ready, Jayne?
Oh, the slot.
Annette. Milton said, I just had dinner with a Fat family and they're a bunch of pigs. Instead of putting the food on plates, they just ate it out of a blank.
Trough.
Right, out of a trough. All right. All right, Marty. All right, there's one for Annette. 4-2 the score. Jayne.
I didn't know how to spell it.
That's it, trough. Spelling's okay. Okay, the score is 4-3. One more for a tie. John.
It's the tie trough.
Uh-huh. 4-4. Sorrell.
Wait a minute here.
It's up to you.
Oh, wait a minute. I
now,
never
wait a minute, Sorrell. There's a lot
man
of
who
pressure.
Plays hog on television.
I know.
Irony, irony.
That's true.
That's true. This is a momentous moment. The hog went for the trough.
Yeah.
Another trough. Come on down, Annette.
Good luck.
Right. right there on that mark, if you would, please. Elizabeth, it was a pleasure to meet you.
Oh, pleasure to meet you.
Good luck in your new marriage,
oh,
and we're going to send some gifts to you for the match game.
Okay,
Elizabeth Tamaret, there she is. Well, we congratulate you. Now we're going to switch to Hollywood Squares. We'll bring on three more stars. John and I will trade places. Lots more excitement coming your way. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive a deluxe convertible dishwasher with the energy saver control that is designed to save on electricity. Seven push buttons provide up to 18 cycle selections. Solid cherry cutting board furnished by White Westinghouse. It's time for more of the Match Game. Hollywood Squares. Our win from Search for Tomorrow. Rod Arrants. From Real People, Bill Rafferty. From Dallas, Fern Fitzgerald. And taking over, the star of the Hollywood Square, John Bowman.
We don't drink, we don't smoke, but we do play Hollywood Squares right after this.
And now, John Bowman and the Hollywood Square.
Oh, Mom.
And then Rune, who is probably happier than a pig in a trough because she has made it through to the Hollywood Squares. Congratulations. Three new celebrities, Fern Fitzgerald.
Hi, darling.
Bill Rafferty.
Hello, John. How you doing?
And Rod Arrants.
Hello.
No one called me darling, but Fern. Hi, Bill.
How you doing, John? You know, I was sitting backstage and Marty told me a wonderful story about his grandmother. You know, when Marty was a young boy up in Northern California, his grandmother took him to the beach, and all of a sudden this wave came and took Marty out to sea. And the grandmother was very upset, and she looked up at the sky and she says, "Oh, dear Lord, please, anything, bring my little Marty back." All of a sudden, the wave returns, deposits Marty on the sand in front of his grandmother. His grandmother looks down, looks up at heaven and goes, "He had a hat."
That's a Vinay Brand joke. Boo some of the Match Game answers. Come on, let's get moving to play Hollywood Square. Here we go.
Get a tux.
Pretty good. All right, before we begin the game, we're going to say hello once again to our defending champ. His name is Ron Washam. His total so far, $33,850. A lot of people with that "may I have a loan" look on their face, Ron. Now, why don't you just tell us about your life to date once again?
Well, I'm a freelance writer, and to make money, I'm a waiter.
You make money
and,
here?
Yeah, I'm doing okay so far, yes.
And
I'm also very, my main
show.
Hobby is wine. Wine collecting and tasting.
Well, you can buy a lot of wine with that $33,850. Probably more than you need, and you could increase that today in Hollywood Squares until you hear the Time's Up bell. Whoever's ahead at that point, as you know, is the winner and goes on to play Supermatch. That can be worth up to $30,000. That's about all you haven't done is pulled the big 30. Our first game is worth $100, $25 for every square. Mr. Washam, your move.
I'll start with Marty, please.
Marty Cohen.
Good choice. John Bowman.
According to the book, Social Usage, is it correct to dunk your donut in public? Or is that rather vulgar?
I suppose you actually mean a donut. This wasn't a euphemism. I like to dunk my donut in coffee, frankly, but I guess you could dunk it in public. I'll say, see, now, Gene, now is when you laugh at the bad ones. I would say that there's absolutely nothing wrong with enjoying a little liquid absorbed into your donut.
Agree or disagree, Ron, that it's okay to dunk your donut in public?
I disagree.
It is rather vulgar to dunk your donut in public. You are rather a good champion. You have made rather correct move once again. First time today, however, you got 25 bucks and an X. Pick a star, Annette, for an O.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn.
All right, Annette.
You have got a mild toothache.
Yes, I've been there.
According to Health Magazine, an ice cube can ease the pain. But where do they recommend you put the ice? Directly on the tooth or between the thumb and first finger of your hand?
Well, they're wrong because it's an acupuncture principle. You stick it right in here and you do that. Right under your arm there.
Stick a chick in there, don't you?
That's right.
Yeah.
Then the tooth will still hurt, but you won't care.
No, so between
It's either directly on the tooth
yeah.
or between the thumb and first finger of your hand, according to Health Magazine.
Well, no, you've got to put it on the tooth because the thing that's causing the pain is the nerve is jangling and going... And if you put the ice there, it'll slow down that motion and ease the pain.
Okay, so he says, for that mild toothache, you should put the ice directly on the tooth. Agree or disagree, Annette?
I disagree.
You should put the ice between the thumb and the first finger. You are right to disagree, and you get the square. Good playing. Could be a tough challenger. According to early indications, there must be some sort of nerve connection there. Some nerve for her, huh, Ron? Pick a star.
I'll pick Jayne, please.
All right, Jayne Kennedy.
Yes.
Your elderly mailman's last request... was to be cremated.
The elderly
mailman.
Mailman?
Yes. Okay. His last request was to be cremated and laid to rest in the Sahara Desert. Will you have to deliver his ashes personally? Or can you send your mailman through the mail?
I'd kiss his ashes. Goodbye.
Is this according to somebody's book?
I guess this is just common knowledge.
Okay, the mailman wants to be cremated and buried in the Sahara Desert. Do I have to take him there, or can I send it through the mail?
Right.
Actually, you can send it in the mail. They have these special vials that you have at the mortuaries or whatever, and you'd have to specially package it. It's not in an envelope that you just jam the ashes in, lick it, and seal it. But you you can put it in a vase, and you can send it parcel post.
It'll never get there.
Okay, so you can send your mailman through the mailman's yes. ashes through the mail. Agree or disagree, Ron?
I agree.
You can mail your mailman's ashes. Yes, you're perfectly right to agree, and you get the square. Yes, well done.
Who opens
Don't
the
forget
ashes?
The stamp. In this case, you'll probably want to leave off the return address. We will return to finish the $100 game right after this. Return with us.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. Now, back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
50 for the champ, 25 for the challenger. Annette Rune, you are playing O. Pick a star.
Michael DeBlock, please.
You missed this one. The first game belongs to Ron. Michael Lembeck.
Here we go, Annette.
During a power blackout, you and your electric eel are sitting all alone in the dark.
Again, Michael.
Can we just
can your
stop?
Eel? Can your eel light up a lamp? Or does he have a different kind of electricity?
John, you rascal, you. Who are we kidding here? No, the eel cannot light up a lamp. He has a different, thing.
To block, agree or disagree, Annette?
I disagree.
An eel can light up a lamp.
Come
You're perfectly
on.
Right to disagree. You get the square and you do block. Plug that in, guys.
Ron, do you want a job
All right,
writing
Ron
for the show?
Ron Washam, she has thwarted you there. Now the shoe is on the other foot. Pick a star.
I'll go with Fern to block, please.
Fern. You missed this one. Annette takes the game in the lead.
Start the joke.
Fern Fitzgerald from Dallas. What is longer, an African chameleon's tongue or his tail?
An African's tongue?
African. No, chameleon.
An African chameleon.
An African.
Chameleon.
The operative word here is chameleon.
I yes. thought you said African comedians, I swear. I swear to God.
I've never dated a chameleon.
The African chameleon's tongue or his tail. Okay. Last time I was kissing an African chameleon, yes, it was definitely the tail. That's longer.
Agree or disagree, Ron?
I disagree.
To block.
I disagree.
His tongue is longer. Yes, you're right.
He's never missed.
You get the square and you do block.
He's never missed the question.
So it's really a hot one back and forth now. You are thwarted there, Annette. Where would you like to place an O?
Marcia to block, please.
First here goes all, 10 minutes.
Apropos the cremation joke, I've decided to be cremated and have my ashes sprinkled on my mother's best rug.
Thank you for that personal note.
You're very welcome. I like
now,
to
try
share
your hand at this. Mm-hmm. Your boyfriend has just given you a pearl necklace. Mm-hmm. You rub the pearls across your teeth, and they feel gravelly. Are they real pearls, or are they a cheap imitation?
Well, the pearls comes out of the nice, from the oyster, you know.
We're hanging on every word.
I know, and you got the set. Gravelly would be good. You don't want a lot of gravel on your neck, you know, it's not attractive, but a little gravel would be fine, and it shows
so
real
if they
pearls.
So if they feel gravelly, they're real
the
pearls.
Ocean. Sure.
Okay, agree or disagree, Annette, to block.
I agree.
If they feel gravelly,
they are real pearls.
Yes. You're right to agree, and you get the square. Well done. It's your teeth that are a cheap imitation. Ron, your move.
I'll take Sorrell to block, please.
All right, Sorrell Booke, boss hog of the Dukes of Hazzard. Does the Great Wall of China have graffiti on it? Or is that something that the Chinese have never done?
Well, there isn't a wall around that doesn't have graffiti. Of course it does.
To block, agree or disagree that the Great Wall of China has graffiti, Ron?
I agree.
There is graffiti on the Great Wall of China. Oh, well done. This is very good play. You're perfectly right to agree, and you get the square. No one's missed one in a while, so we got a real barn burner going. We're going to be back to finish it after this. 100 for the champ, 75 for the challenger, but really that's not so important. What is most important is the winning of this game. Annette, your move.
Build a block.
Right.
Build a block.
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 There's an echo in here, John.
You missed this one. The game belongs to the champ. Bill Rafferty, you are a middle-aged, divorced woman.
Yes. What? Yes. Have you been in my dressing room?
Not yet. Has he been in your dress?
You're a middle-aged, divorced woman. Now that I know this, I'm thinking of coming over. Now that you're once again facing the world of dating, Bill.
Yes.
You want to go out with men, but not to bed with them.
That's right.
According to Dear Abby, should you make that clear when you accept a date? Or should you just wait and see what happens?
Well, I'll tell you something, John. You see, Abby always talks like this. She wouldn't have an affair. I think that you should wait until it happens. I think you should trust in the good intentions of your date. And
just
you
wait
should
and
wait
see what
until
happens.
It happens.
Okay, agree or disagree, Annette, to block.
And I agree.
According to Dear Abby, you should just wait and see what
happens.
You're right to agree. You get the square and you do block. So we have come the whole nine yards, or the whole eight squares, depending on how you look at it. There's only one space left on the board. You get this question right, Ron, you win the game. You miss it, your opponent wins. As a formality, you have to state the square.
Rod to win.
Rod Arrants, from Search for Tomorrow, to win.
Yes.
You are the average American employee, Rod.
Yeah. You're telling me.
You're fired.
When are you more likely, you're on the right track, when are you more likely to get fired? First thing in the morning? Or at quitting time?
Right now.
Based on my experience, at quitting time.
For the game, agree or disagree, that you're more likely to get fired at quitting time, Ron.
I agree.
The average American employee is more likely to get fired at quitting time. You're right to agree, you get the square, and you win the game. Congratulations. In one of the most flawlessly played Hollywood Squares games we have had to date. Very few questions, if any, missed. I wasn't really watching for that, but you have taken the lead, 325 to 100. We still have time. Take the X's and O's off of the board. Annette, start us off on the next game.
Marty, please.
Marty Cohen.
Okay, I hope you're looking
at it. Marty.
Who popularized the expression, often a bridesmaid, never a bride? Was it Shakespeare in Romeo and Juliet? Or was it from a Listerine commercial?
Michelle Triolo.
Often a bridesmaid, never a bride. Was it from a Listerine commercial?
John,
it
certainly
these people
wasn't
are intelligent,
Taylor.
Educated people. It would obviously be from Romeo and Juliet.
Agree or disagree, Annette?
I disagree.
It was from a Listerine commercial.
See? You're
perfectly right to disagree, and you get the square. It's still very, very close. Let's keep it moving. Ron Washam, your move.
Gene Rayburn, please.
Okay, Gene.
Here we go.
Gene.
You're attending a steak dinner at the White House, and you're seated at the president's table. It's getting late. You have to go. Is it all right to leave the party before the president does, or would that be a tacky thing to do?
That would be, excuse me, it would be a breach of etiquette to leave before the host leaves.
That's tacky. Agree or disagree, Ron?
I agree.
That would be a tacky thing to do. You're perfectly right to agree. You keep the string going, and you get the square, an X and an O on the board so far. Annette Roon, pick a star.
Jayne, please.
Jayne Kennedy. In his new movie, Lassiter, does Tom Selleck shave his mustache, or does he wear a feathered negligee?
Well, I didn't see the movie, and I'm really looking forward to it because they've got those gorgeous posters, and he's got that full mustache, and I didn't see him wear a negligee. I'd love to see him wear a negligee, but I'd have to say he didn't shave his mustache, so it must be that he wore the negligee.
Agree or disagree, Annette?
I agree.
In his new movie, Lassiter, Tom Selleck wears a feathered negligee.
Thank
You're
you.
Right to agree. You get the square. All right, two O's up there, and you are playing X, Ron Washam. Pick a star.
I'll pick Michael the Block, please.
You missed this one. The game and the lead goes to Annette. Michael Lembeck,
yes.
Whose milk is higher in calories?
What's that again?
Whose milk is higher in calories? Cow's milk or mother's milk?
I love you, John. Cow's milk or mother's milk is higher in calories? I'm going to say mother's milk.
What are you going to say to Block, Ron? Agree or disagree?
I disagree.
Higher in calories is mother's milk. The string is broken. You should have agreed. Your opponent gets the square and wins the game. Whoa! The bell means that time is up. You have done the net rude. $375. You're a new champ. Congratulations. Zipped her way over to join Jean Rayburn. Get ready for a shot at potentially $30,000. That was one of the most amazingly well-played set of games that we have had. It came down to one question,
sure
which
did.
Fittingly enough was one of the few missed questions all along, but you certainly have played well in your stint here on the show. You have $33,850. You were a great champ.
Thank you very
Ron
much.
Ron Washam.
Thank you.
Jean T.
Okay, John, here we are with a champ. And we'll be back with her and the nine stars for a go at the $30,000 right after this. And now, here to play the Super Match is Jayne Rayburn. Thank you, Jayne. Here we go. Well, Annette, I hope you do as well, at least as well as Ron did. He left here with a grand total of $34,100.
Oh, I'd love to.
You would love to?
Yes.
All right, let's begin with this super match. You can win up to $30,000 here. We polled the studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Al blank. If you give us the answer they wrote most often, it's $1,000. For the second most popular, $500. And for the third, $250. Now, whom do you call on for a little assist here?
John?
Al Capone.
There's one.
Jayne.
Al Hurt.
Al Hurt.
Bill.
Yankovic.
No, that's a real
that
answer.
Eat
Al,
it.
Yeah, is that the guy?
Al Yankovic is a musician, right?
Right. Yes, Weird Al Yankovic.
Weird Al Yankovic.
All right, so you have Al
there,
Yankovic, Al Capone, and what was the other one?
Al Hurt. Al Hurt.
Oh, Al Hurt, the trumpet player. So, those are the three. Now you have to make a decision. Choose one of those from among those three, or think up one of your own.
I'm going to go with Capone.
You go with Capone?
Yeah.
All right, she's made up her mind very quickly, and she's very definite about it. Al Capone, she says, is up there, and probably in the big number. Who knows? We'll find out right now by revealing the $250 response. Al Jolson. I walk a million miles from one of your smiles. All right, the $500 answer says Al Pacino. So far,
Zippo. Zipperoo.
Terrific bunch.
Always pulls it out under pressure.
All right, here's your last chance.
This could be Weird Al Yankovic.
Al Capone, slide the big one. Okay. Now you got your $1,000. Look at that. Isn't that wonderful? Time now for the head-to-head match with any star you choose. And after you've made your decision, the star will reveal a hidden number. It'll be a 10, a 20, or a 30. And we'll multiply your $1,000 by whatever number is revealed. Okay, Annette, choose a star.
I hope he's as lucky for me, John.
Okay. I hope he's as lucky for me, John.
Oh, as he was for the last.
Oh, as he was for Ron.
Yeah.
All right, here we go.
Ron lost with John.
What do you want to know?
Yeah, Ron lost.
I have to pull this.
Oh, you got to lift it. Right. Ready, set, go. $10,000 is what you're playing for. Good luck, Annette. Ready, John. Blank night. N-I-G-H-T. Blank night. Blank night. All right, Annette, you collect the $10,000 if you match John. There it is.
Silent.
Silent night. All right. Well, it's here we are in the latter part of March, and she says silent night, John.
La 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 la. Tis the season to be jolly. La 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 la.
We don't drink. We don't smoke. We do say silent night.
Good night. Silent night. Very good. You've got a grand total of $11,375. Good for you, Annette. We'll be back with Annette and our stars right after this.
Okay. Now we want to find out which star had the large number. Would you all grab the tabs? Ready, set, go.
What are you going to learn? When you
Michael Lembeck had
it.
The big number was right there.
Well,
listen, this is a winning combination here because they both came up with the same answer, a remarkable feat.
And there was another very good answer.
That's
good
right.
Night.
Good night was
good
a wonderful
night.
Answer.
Good, I would say.
You were terrific stars. We'll see you tomorrow. Jayne Rayburn inviting you to join us tomorrow.
John Bauman saying so long for the Match Game Hollywood Squares era. Good night.
A member of our studio audience will receive Oneida Silversmith's gift certificate for a beautiful assortment of gifts for your entertaining and enjoyment, including your choice of luxurious stainless flatware and silver-plated hollowware furnished by Oneida Silversmith. This is Gene Wood speaking for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. A Mark Goodson, Television Productions.